Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can print some of these following series. So here you can see first series will print some of natural numbers, second to add odd numbers, third to add even numbers, fourth to add squares of natural numbers, and last one is cubes of natural numbers. So with the help of single program, I will tell you how you can print these series. So I will change that program minorly. So first I will be implementing some of natural numbers, then I will convert it into this and so on, right? So these are variables. First is n, then I, and then s equals to 0. So n will be reading the value, like how many digits you want to add. So printf will display the message enter value of n, then that entered number will be stored inside n variable. Now we need to rotate the loop. So loop will start from 1, it will iterate n times. So I is initially 1, condition will be checked, and every time this loop will be incremented by 1, right? So now inside this loop, I am going to calculate sum. So first I am calculating this sum of natural numbers. So here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be provided by I, because I is every time incremented by 1. So I can write s equals to s plus I. So this way, all the natural numbers will be added into s. After completion of this loop, I can print sum equals to %d and then s. So this way, this loop will calculate sum of all the digits n times. So let's say n is 10. So it will calculate sum of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 10. So all digits from 1 to 10 will be added, and their sum will be displayed on output screen. So this way you can print sum of this series. Now next comes sum of odd numbers. So here we need to add 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 up to n times. So beginning of the program will be same, but in place of I, now we need another variable so that we can have odd numbers. So I am going to declare one more variable. Let's say v equals to 1. And here instead of I am adding v into s, and then I am applying this. V equals to v plus 2. So first time you can see s is 0, v is 1. So 0 plus 1 will be added and s will be 1. So after first rotation, s will be 1 and v will become 3, because its initial value is 1. So 1 plus 2, it will become 3. Then I will be incremented, condition will be checked. Now you need to add this. So here s is 1 and we need to add v. So 3 plus 1, so new value will be 4. And here v is 3. So 3 plus 2, v becomes 5. So this way, v is having all the odd numbers, and those odd numbers are added with s so that we can calculate the sum. And after completion of this loop, value of s will be printed, right? So n times odd numbers will be added and their sum will be displayed. So this I also explained you. Now you have to print sum of even numbers. So it is very simple. You can start v from 2. Instead of starting it from 1, you can start it from 2. So first 2 will be added, then 2 plus 2 will be 4. So next time 4 will be added, similarly 6 and so on. So this is very simple. So you need to change this only for printing sum of even numbers. Rest of the process will be same. Now I am coming to this. So here you can see it is printing sum of squares of natural numbers. So 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square. So this way we need to add all the squares of natural numbers. So here I am removing this variable and writing this. So I am adding I into I. So this way I am able to calculate square of natural number, because natural numbers are available in I variable. So I will be multiplied with I and the result will be added into S variable. So this way you can print this output. So all the squares of natural numbers will be added into S. After completion of this loop, S will be printed as a sum of that series. Now this you can easily implement because this is cubes of natural number. So here you can add one more multiplication. So here you can see I is having natural number and this is multiplied 3 times so that we can calculate its cube, and that cube value will be added into S. After completion of this loop, all the sum that is contained inside S variable will be displayed as output on output screen as output or result. So this way you can print sum of any series with the help of this program. So do implement this on your system so that you will be able to understand how it is working. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, so you can go to details of this video. There you will find links of various playlists. So keep watching those videos so that you can learn programming in easy way. Thank you for watching this video.